Stories of UFO sightings have been ordinary knowledge over the last 100 years. Every now and then we come across a report of a UFO being spotted in some part of the world. Whether it is out of the static ordinary lights in the sky or inconsistent movement of objects, individuals have, on several times, been sure of catching the sights of aliens and their UFOs. In this video, we bring to you some of the most fascinating encounters that humans have supposedly had with our counterparts from the world unknown. Here's a look at a few of history's most famous UFO sightings of all time. Number 1. The Kenneth Arnold Sighting, 1947. On June 24, 1947, a private pilot named Kenneth Arnold was flying in the state of Washington in his Call Air A2 airplane when he saw a sequence of bright flashes coming from north of Mount Rainier. When he later compared their movements to flying saucer, the press picked it up, and so began our modern obsession with flying saucers and UFOs. The claims were taken seriously by US administrators as, 10 days after Arnold's experience, they were verified when a United Airlines crew on a plane to Seattle sighted 5 to 9 disc-like objects that kept speed with their aircraft for 10 to 15 minutes. Other spectators also came forward saying they had seen silver disc-like objects from the ground, and many sighting reports were filed by the US government. During his explanation, Arnold claimed the objects were too speedy to be any existing human aircraft, and that they easily leaped in and out of valleys with impressive movement. Arnold's sightings led to the establishment of Project Sign at the end of 1947, the first publicly accepted US Air Force UFO investigation. Project Sign developed into Project Grudge, which then became called Project Blue Book. Number 2. The Roswell UFO Incident, 1947. Only a few weeks after Arnold's discovery, came an event that has gone down as the most well-known in UFO history to date. In the summer of 1947, rancher William Brazel came across strange debris, chunks of plastic, including metallic rods, and uncommon papery scraps, in one of his New Mexico fields. After Brazel was notified about the wreckage, soldiers from the nearby Roswell Army Air Force Base came to recover the materials. News headlines at the time stated that a flying saucer crashed in Roswell. Though the U.S. Army Air Force ultimately stated that the object was part of an experimental nuclear test, detecting balloon technology created for the highly secret project mogul, Jesse Marcel, the official who first assessed the crash site, opposed this with the following explanation. "It was not something from this earth that I'm quite sure of. I was acquainted with just about all the equipment used in aircraft and/or air travel. This was nothing like that. It could not have been." Nonetheless, there are still people who support the UFO theory and believe that the administrators and the military are covering up the truth about alien arrival at and around Roswell. Hundreds of thousands of curiosity seekers visit the crash site every year, hoping to find out the truth for themselves. Before we move forward, please don't forget to hit the subscribe button and turn on the notification bell to get notified about our future videos. Number 3. The Kecksburg UFO Incident, 1965. This incident happened on December 9, 1965, at Kecksburg, Pennsylvania, the United States in North America, when a fireball was stated by natives of 6 U.S. states and Canada over Michigan, Detroit, and Windsor, Canada. Astronomers said it was possible a meteor bolide blazing up in the atmosphere and coming down at a steep angle. NASA delivered a statement in 2005, stating that experts had examined bits and pieces from the area and identified they were from a Soviet satellite, but records of their findings were lost in the 1990s. NASA answered to court orders and Freedom of Information Act requests to search for the records. The event gained wide fame in popular culture and UFO logging, with different beliefs ranging from alien craft to wreckage from the Soviet space probe Cosmos 96, and is often known as Pennsylvania's Roswell. Number 4. Westall UFO, 1966. At around 11 a.m. on Wednesday, 6 April 1966, a class of students and a teacher from Westall Secondary College were just finishing a sports activity on the main oval when an object, detailed as being a gray saucer-shaped craft with a light purple color and being about twice the size of a family car, was claimed to have been seen. Witness details were mixed. A science teacher, Andrew Greenwood, told the Dandenong Journal at that time that he viewed a silvery green disc. As per the witnesses, the object was coming down and then intersect and overflew the high school's southwest corner, going in a southeasterly way, before vanishing from sight as it came down behind a grove of trees and into a paddock at the Grange in front of the Westall State School. After a short period around 20 minutes, the object then moved up at speed, leaving towards the northwest. As the object acquired altitude, some accounts reported as having been followed from the scene by five unknown aircraft which circled the object. Some described one disc, some reported to have seen three. Number 5. The Tehran UFO Incident, 1976. The September 19, 1976, event in Tehran, Iran, started with phone calls from worried citizens, stating a bright light in the sky. Iran's military sent out F-4 fighter jets to look over. As they got nearer to the object, their devices started to break down. One pilot said he saw a bright flash being released from the UFO, thinking it was a missile sent his direction. The pilot tried to open fire, but defective equipment didn't let him discharge any rounds. Some assume the bright flashes may have been Jupiter, which was particularly bright in the sky that night. The burning object may have been meteors that were seen above Iran the same day. Others think the object was a UFO. Number 6. Rendlesham Forest Eyewitness Accounts, 1980. The Rendlesham Forest UFO event, which took place in the county of Suffolk in the United Kingdom, was classified as being one of the few cases where witnesses said they saw a craft land after encircling through trees in a forest. The US Air Force was positioned at a Royal Air Force base at the time said, "I moved a little closer, I walked around the craft, and finally, I walked right up to the craft. I noticed the fabric of the shell was more like a smooth, hazy, black glass." While the UK's Ministry of Defence reported that the lights seen were caused by the nearby Orfordness Lighthouse, witnesses still claim, to this day, that they saw something that does belong to this earth, and since this event has been covered up. Number 7. The Belgian UFO Wave, 1989-90. The Belgian UFO Wave is particularly notable because it involves around 13,500 individuals who claim to have an eye witnessed the event, which took place over several months. At the end of November 1989, natives of Belgium claimed to see a large triangular UFO floating in the sky. In March of 1990, new sightings were verified by two military radar stations. Two F-16 fighter jets were sent out to look over. Though the pilots could not see anything, they were able to radar lock onto an extremely fast-moving object that quickly vanished, using their radar. This photo was widely famous for a few months after the event took place, though somebody later came forward to say he had faked the image. The Belgian Air Force has acknowledged having no logical explanation for the activity. Number 8. The Phoenix Lights, 1997. On March 13, 1997, between 7:30 and 10:30 p.m., a huge amount of people reported seeing unusual, bright lights over Nevada, Arizona, and part of Mexico. The first incident to be seen is detailed as a V-shaped object flying through the sky, which was approximately the size of a commercial airplane. According to Qatar.com, one eyewitness said, "We don't have anything that big," he said. "It was totally silent. I've never seen anything even close to the colors from the exhaust that propelled that thing. It was as big as downtown Prescott and totally blocked out the stars." Number 9. The lights above the New Jersey Turnpike, 2001. On July 14, 2001, many drivers on the New Jersey Turnpike paused for around 15 minutes just after midnight to see a strange orange and yellow lights that were shaped in a V form over the Arthur Kill Waterway between Staten Island, New York, and Carteret, New Jersey. One of the eyewitnesses was Carteret Police Department's Lieutenant Daniel Tarrant. While air traffic controllers refused that any military jets, planes, or space flights could have caused the lights, a group, called the New York Strange Phenomena Investigators, New York SPY, reported they have FAA radar data that confirms the UFO sightings from that night. Number 10. The USS Nimitz Encounter, 2004. On November 14, 2004, part of the USS Nimitz carrier strike group, the USS Princeton, discovered an uncommon craft on its radar 100 miles off the coast of San Diego. 2 weeks following the discovery, the carrier's crew was tracking objects that emerged at 80,000 feet before diving to drift right above the Pacific Ocean. When two F-18F fighter jets from the aircraft carrier USS Nimitz got in the area, they noticed a white tic-tac-shaped object appear from the water. It had no seeable markings to show an engine, wings or windows, and inflamed monitors didn't reveal any exhaust. It speeded away at twice the top speed of the fighter jets. Video from the encounter is among the three UFO videos lately declassified by the US Navy. Number 11. The O'Hare International Airport Sighting, 2006. On November 7, 2006, Flight 446 was getting ready to fly to North Carolina from Chicago's O'Hare International Airport when a United Airlines member on the tarmac saw a dark metallic craft floating over Gate C-17. A total of 12 members as well as a few witnesses outside the airport later spotted the disc-shaped craft. The witnesses stated that the saucer floated for about 5 minutes before quickly moving up through the clouds, leaving a blue hole in the cloud cover. O'Hare controller and Union officer Craig Burzich hilariously claimed at the time that, to fly 7 million light years to O'Hare and then have to turn around and go home because your gate was occupied is simply unacceptable. The Chicago Tribune stated at the time that people were upset that neither the government nor the airline investigated the event and dismissed it as a weather phenomenon. Number 12. The East Coast Flying Saucer Sighting, 2015. A video leaked in 2017 at the same time as news of the Advanced Aviation Threat Identification Program. It reveals an encounter between an F-A-18 Super Hornet and an unidentified flying object that was very similar to the craft spotted off San Diego in 2004. No clarification ever emerged, though the video is among the three that has been declassified and let out to the public by the U.S. Navy in order to clear up any misunderstanding about whether the video is real or not. The pilots tracked the object at 25,000 feet above the Atlantic Ocean as it flew away, while also rotating on its axis. Number 13. Project Grudge Report 13 and Mutilated Farm Animals, latest 2019. In March 1956, UFOlogist Information said that Air Force Sergeant Jonathan Pilavet and Major William Cunningham were searching for dispersed wreckage from a recent rocket in the White Sands Missile Testing Grounds near Holloman Air Force Base in New Mexico, when, as history writes, Cunningham all of a sudden heard a loud scream from Lavette. Cunningham quickly crossed the dune he was on, thinking that Lavette had been bitten by a snake. Instead, he reported having seen the official with a long snake-like arm covered around his legs being dragged into a silver disc floating above the ground. The craft then pulled Lavette inside, the officer stated, and rose straight into the sky. After Cunningham claimed the incident, he was taken in for a psychiatric examination, and searches were released for Sergeant Lavette. After 3 days, Lavette's nude infected body was found. All of his organs were gone. It was noted that they had been removed with utmost precision. According to UFOlogists, this story counts for report number 13 of the US government's Project Grudge reports. 1 to 12 and 14 are now made public, but 13 remains a secret. What's more, mutilations of the same mysterious nature have been reported in animals as recently as last year. As Alexander Wendt and Raymond Duval advise in a study called Sovereignty in the UFO, an authoritative UFO ban exists due to the fact that knowing could turn our society upside down. What do you think? Are UFOs, also known as UAPs, understandable if we just take the time to research them? Are they even worth researching in the first place? So, that's it from our side. What do you think of our list? Do you agree with all incidents that we mentioned? Do you know about any other UFO sightings apart from this list? Let us know in the comments. Also, please don't forget to like, share this video with your friends, and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content like today. We hope you enjoyed our video and we will see you next time.